All right, guys, let me start this video first with a thank you. The other day I put out, a request to help get a computer for a friend of ours, and that request has been met. And I want to thank, those that stepped up. You know who you are, that purchased a computer and had that done. Well, very much thank you. We've come under a lot of attack lately because of what I do. And that's okay, because that's the way it's supposed to do. That's the way it's supposed to happen. Just like a pilot, when you're over the target, you're going to take the most fire, which is good. We know we're on top of it. Now, what I want to do in this video is I want to show you the significance, the actual meaning, the real deep spiritual meaning behind the Arch of Baal, Baal-Zebub. I want to show you what it means, what it really means, why they're putting it where they're putting it in New York. What the possible outcomes may be. It doesn't mean it has to happen, but we have a lot of possibilities, and we should explore those possibilities to the fullest extent. I want to give you an education, a supernatural spiritual education right now, and I want you to take this in and understand this. Because just like the video I did where I said we're going to do a new venue, this is all about owning one thing. It's about a new race of beings taking over. So it's about a new race of beings taking over. And it's literally God's angels being destroyed by Satan and his demons. And we are a food source. We have become a source of energy to create this new race of beings. Now, I'm going to continue with the venue I told you about, where I'm going to have you guys listen to audio tracks from commercials. And then I'm going to ask you, what's the commercial about? Just by hearing it. And then I'm going to let you actually watch it. And then we're going to break it down so you guys can understand they are not selling products. They are propagating a venue. They're using commercials as what's called a vehicle of distribution, and they're distributing their nefarious plans in plain sight is what they're doing. It's really easy to see. Once you see it, it's so easy to see. So we're going to start this video right now with a short little education, and then we're going to move right into the Arch of Baal. So I'll try and make this short and to the point. So stay with me. Okay. Let's look at Genesis very quick. Let's look at Genesis 3, where it all started. Okay, so there's this tree that's in the midst of the garden. Think of a circle cut in half. That's what the word midst means when you translate it. It means to bisect, like to bisect a circle. Well, there's this tree that Adam and Eve are not supposed to touch. It says, neither shall you touch it, right there, lest you die. The word touch means to lay with, like a woman. Go look it up. Don't believe me. Look it up yourself. It means to lay with, like a woman. Neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Okay, now I want to show you what the serpent, the word for serpent is Nakash. It is not a snake. It is called a serpent because of a hissing sound it makes when it speaks. Like, go watch the old Jungle Book. Remember, Ka say a delicious and come like that. Okay, so, and the serpent said to the woman, the word woman is Isha Nashim. It means woman, and the first declination is adulteress. Go look it up. I've done all kinds of videos on this. Now, there's all kinds of other words for woman, but the reason Isha, Nashim was chosen is because it incorporates the word adulteress. And that's what happened in this whole grand scheme that we're in. I want to show you something. The serpent said to the woman, you shall not surely die. Okay, that was a lie, because that's when we died spiritually to God. And then the serpent said, for God doth know in the day you eat thereof, your eyes shall be open and you shall be as gods. When that happened, you shall be as gods. Man becoming a god, there's a word for that. It's called apotheosis. That's what the definition is. Let me show it to you. Apotheosis. the elevation of someone to divine status, deification, culmination or climax, the highest point in the development of something, culmination or climax. Now think about the human race, the highest point in development, okay? Because I'm going to show you where this all plays out. This is just all supernatural. It's going to blow your mind. It's amazing information. It's all from the Lord. I'm not this smart. This is the Lord's gift. Okay, so apotheosis. It means man becoming a god. Well, by the way, in Genesis, when the serpent, the Nakah, said to the adulteress, "You shall not surely die," that was a lie. So the serpent lied. "God hath known the day you eat thereof, your eyes shall be opened." That was true. "And you shall be as gods." Now watch. And then she took the fruit, and then she went and gave it to Adam. So the woman was used to bring down Adam. Now watch. Let's go to Genesis 3:22. And so they've fallen. The fall has occurred. And the Lord God said, "Behold, man has become as," right there, "one of us, gods." This is it. 3:22, look, chapter 3, verse 22. Verse 22. "Man has become as one of us, to know good and evil. Now, lest he put forth his hand and take also of the tree of life and eat and live forever." That's why we have to be redeemed by Christ. This is the reason, right here. Okay, so now that we know right here in Genesis 3:22, man has become a god. But it meant death for humanity. Let me give you a nice example of that. There's a club. It's called the Skull and Bones Club. And they have the number 3:22. That's why it is. That's why they use 3:22. Because man has become a god, but it equaled death for the human race. You understand? Okay, so that's why the Skull and Bones Club, the ones that are our keepers, our handlers, the elite that handle and they basically, you know, run the human race through their shadow government, they are the keepers of the slaves. These are the guys. The Skull and Bone Club, Genesis 3:22. That's why, that's their number, Skull and Bones, because we died right here. "You shall not surely die." It was a lie. Skull and Bones. "Man has become as one of us," 3:22. Genesis 3:22, okay? Now, let's continue, okay? Now, it says in Genesis, "You shall not surely die, for God doth know in the day you eat thereof, your eyes shall be opened, and you shall be as gods." Okay, watch my eyes. I'm going to close my eyes. Now I'm going to open my eyes. Let me show you the Coco Mademoiselle commercial one more time. How does the commercial start? The eyes are closed. The eye is closed. This is the all-seeing eye opening up in humanity. Think of it as an internet connection to the devil, a straight up new server for humanity. Because now, listen to the music. The way she lied. Now, here's the bait. I'm sorry, let's go back. So, here's the bait. The reason she has her leg like this is it's a triangle, and then you'll see the light here. She's going to lean behind a piece of glass, so her identity is really concealed. She's going to take the bottle of cocoa. She's going to turn it upside down. She's going to make a 666 with her finger and then put it on herself like the serpent put it on her. This is what was used to bring down Adam. Now watch. There you go. Now, there you go. There was the 666 right there. Let me go back. Right there, 666. And she turns it upside down and puts it on herself. Now she makes the offer to him. She's like, she holds it out. Here you go. Kind of like the fruit. Here, Adam, take this. And now she tosses it on the other side of her. And when he touches it, watch, deal done. Now, she threw it on the inside. She threw it behind her because she threw it in the trap, in the snare. And watch where he ends up. Now, what looks good, what looks like the light, is really darkness. See? Light turns to dark, Lucifer. And now here comes the knockout. He's like, what happened? Well, this is the Garden of Eden, people. I don't care what anybody says. That's what this is. And watch what happens. He gets a knockout punch, and then he's cast down, and he's in the trap in the all-seen eye, the intersection of the two circles, the vesica piscis. Watch. Knockout punch, trapped, cast down in the intersection of the two, all-seen eye. I mean, that's just all there is to it. This commercial is the Garden of Eden. There it is. And he's trapped. There he is. In the intersection of the two sets. Seed of the serpent, seed of the woman. Everyone's trapped. That's it. That's the all-seeing eye. Mind you, football, it should. That's everything comes from this. Everything comes from this. Okay, so now, let me continue to educate you. 1 Corinthians 3:13, know ye not that you are the temple of God, and the Spirit of God dwelleth in you? Okay, so we are the temple. You have to be born again to become the temple of the Lord God. Otherwise, you're not the temple of the Lord God. You're in abeyance, kind of. You're hoping to be. But unless you're born again, you're not. That's all there is to it. You have a different spirit until you're born again. And those two parts of you are in conflict. Always, always in conflict. And I'm just going to do this in front of you. Watch. We're going to go to 1 Ephesians 2. We're going to go to Ephesians 2, and let me show you what Jesus' purpose was, okay? So you understand what this is all about. Okay, so, you know, and you he hath quickened who are dead in your trespasses and sins, wherein in past times you walked according to the course of this world. Look, according to the prince of the power of the air. Look at this. The Spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. So until you're saved, you have a different spirit. You have the spirit of the prince of the power of the air. And once you get born again, you get the Holy Spirit. It's different. It's your down payment on everlasting life. Now watch. That works in the heart of the children of disobedience, among whom also we had our conversation in times past in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind. Because, see, we were slaves to it. We were caught in that trap I just showed you, in the all-seeing eye. We are the all-seeing eye until you get saved. Then you become a child of God. Then you're adopted by God, and you cry out, Abba, Father. And we're by nature children of wrath, as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love, wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, he has quickened us together with Christ. By grace you are saved. And he has raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness towards us through Jesus Christ. For grace you are saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Your salvation wasn't your idea. If you came to Christ, it's because the Father led you to Christ. It wasn't your idea. He's the one that led you. Now let me show you what the whole thing is. Watch this. For he is our peace, who has made both one. Now you got to pay attention. Made both one. Look. He has made the two into one. Well, Satan's doing the same thing, but in a different direction. He's making the two host bodies into one as a temple for him to occupy. And I'm going to show you the meaning of the Arch of Baal, the meaning of the Twin Towers, the One World Freedom Tower. It's all right here in the Bible. For he is our peace, who has made both one and has broken down the middle wall of partition. Let me show you what that looks like. And just let me show you what that looks like. Google. We'll do images. Three crosses at Calvary. Three crosses at Calvary. This is what it looks like. The middle wall of partition. So here we go. Let me show you what this looks like. Let's let this load up. So you can see what Jesus' job was. I want to explain this to you. I want you to see it. Okay, let me just find a good image. Okay, this is good enough. We can use this one. So, you know what? I'm going to use a better image. Three crosses. Passion of Christ. The reason I want to use that is I want to make a point with the guys that were on the crosses. Okay, so if you saw the Passion of Christ, you'll remember there were two guys that were really, there was one guy, Dismas and Jesmus, and one guy was really rude and hateful, and the other guy was repentant. I don't know if y'all remember that. Hopefully you saw it. Having a little trouble finding that image. But I'll use this image right here. So here we go. So here is a representation of the human condition. There's a good you, and there's a bad you. Even though they're both under condemnation, Christ stands in the middle, reconciling this one and this one through the cross back to God. Think of an arrow going up. So he has an arm reaching out to this side and an arm reaching out to this side to unite the two halves, like the good you and the bad you. And so Christ is in the middle reconciling the two to make peace, because that is your internal condition inside of you. There's a good you, there's a bad you. There's a good Jonathan and a bad Jonathan. And God reconciled me in 2002 in an alley in the presence of an angel. And I don't care if anyone believes me. It's the truth. My testimony is proven out. So here it is. Look what it says. For he is our peace, who has made both one, having broken down the middle wall of partition between us, having abolished in his flesh the enmity. The enmity. Where did the enmity start? Let me show you. The enmity started right here in Genesis 3. So because thou hast hearkened to the voice of thy wife, and oh, here we go. In Genesis 3, here we go. When he's talking to the serpent. So God's talking to the serpent now, he said, and the Lord said to the serpent, because you have done this, thou art cursed above all the cattle, every beast of the field. And you shall go about and dust thou shalt eat. Well, they were made of dust, weren't they? Dust thou shalt eat all the days of life. Look at this. And I will put what? Between thee and the woman, between thy seed and her seed. I will put what? What will he put? Enmity. So there's enmity between the seed of the serpent and the seed of the woman. And Jesus's mission was to abolish in his flesh the enmity. The enmity between the two. His purpose was, even the law of commandments contained in ordinance, for to make in himself, in Christ, of the two, of the twain, one new man, so making peace, that he might reconcile, what does that say right there? Both to God through the cross. This is a representation of inside of you. That's what's going on. Okay, so now that I've shown you scripturally how obvious this is, let's move to the meaning, the deep meaning of what's going on with the Arch of Baal coming to New York. What is the real meaning behind it? If you know the real meaning behind these things, then everything's going to make sense to you. So let's look at some stuff I'm going to show you. These are our show notes right here. I will put this link right here in the description box. And you need to get this show note link. This, by the way, this is what Dave does. Dave puts these together for us. We have all of these. We've saved all these notes for all these years. And this stuff is more valuable than gold. This is the wisdom of God. It's so much more valuable than money. This is, you can't buy this. I'm going to show you what this all means. I'm going to explain to you what this means now. So I hope you just take a moment, say a little prayer and say, God, you know, open my heart, open my mind. You know, if this is you, if this is of you, let me see it. Let me tell you something, guys. Not everybody's meant to understand this. I'll use the scriptures. Matthew 13. To you it has been given to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. To them it has not been given. It's the story of this, the wheat and the weeds. The story of the wheat and the weeds. The Son of Man sowed the good seed. And then the devil sowed the bad seed that tares amongst the wheat. It's right here. There it is right there. Right in Genesis. And the devil sowed the tares amongst the wheat. Let both grow together until the harvest. And then I will cut down all those that cause sin. There they are growing together, the wheat and the weeds. That's why the Twin Towers were built to resemble giant DNA markers. I'm going to show you actual DNA markers right now. You want to see what a DNA marker looks like? Those are actual DNA markers. I had Dave the Wave cut them out and put them under the Arch of Washington. By the way, this Arch of Washington, I'm going to give you a little history on right now. Okay, remember, these are DNA markers. The Twin Towers were literally built to resemble giant DNA markers. That's so far above human thinking that most people can't think that way, but that's my spiritual gifting. I can see it. It's not even a question. It's what it is. So, just stay tuned and watch. Get ready to freak out. Let's talk about this arch that's got this unbelievable representation of two DNAs. Let's talk about this arch real quick. Let's bring it up. This is called the Arch of Washington. Do you know anything about it? Do you know anything about this arch? I know everything about it. Let me show you. Well, when I say everything, I know a lot about it. This is the Washington Arch. Here it is right here again, right? The Washington Square Arch, constructed of white Tuckahoe marble, Westchester marble, was modeled by Stanford White, on the Arc de Triomphe. Do y'all know what the Arc de Triomphe is? Well, let me show you what, you know what the Arc de Triomphe means? It means the Arch of Triumph. Let me show you what the Arc de Triomphe is. There it is. It's in Paris, you know. People go to Paris, and they want to see the Arc de Triomphe at the Champs-Élysées, or whatever it's called, where you go in the circle, right? So there's the Arc de Triomphe. The Arc de Triomphe, it means the Arch of Triumph. So the Washington Square Arch was modeled after the Arch de Triomphe built in Paris in 1806. And itself was modeled after the Arch of Titus. So the Arch of Washington right here was modeled after the Arch of Titus. This arch in Manhattan, which was modeled after the Arc de Triomphe, which means the Arch of Triumph, itself modeled after the Arch of Titus. Let's go look at the Arch of Titus. Let me tell you who Titus was. Okay. Watch this. Here's Titus. Let me go up a little bit. Here's Titus right here. Here he is right here. He's a Roman emperor. Titus, right here, Titus was left in charge of ending the Jewish rebellion in 70 AD. He besieged and captured Jerusalem. You heard about the 9th of Av, right? 9/11, when the Twin Towers were destroyed? Well, guess what? On the 9th of Av, the ninth day of the 11th month of the Hebrew calendar of 9/11, this guy right here, Titus, destroyed the city and he destroyed the second temple. Remember the one where Jesus said, "Verily, do you not see all these things? Verily, I tell you, there shall not be one stone left on top of another that shall not be thrown down." Well, the disciples wanted to show Jesus the beautiful buildings, right? The beautiful buildings. Let me prove it to you. Okay, well, this guy right here destroyed the building that was called the temple. He destroyed the second temple. For this achievement, Titus was awarded, look, a triumph. Triumph, Arc de Triomphe. Okay, the Arch of Titus. The Arch of Titus commemorates the victory to this day. There it is. There's the Arch of Titus right there. Okay, well, let me show you something. See the Arch of Titus? Here it is right here. The soffit under here, the soffit in the axial archway is deeply coffered with reliefs of, what does that say? Of the what? Apotheosis of Titus. Oh my gosh, we're back to Genesis 3:22. Man has become as one of us. So the Arch of Titus is an arch of triumph that man has become a god. That's what that is. You're looking right at it. I'm showing it to you. These are facts. I'm not just coming up with this. You're looking at it. That's it. It's what it is. It is the apotheosis of Titus. Man becoming a god. How did that happen? Well, in Genesis 3, it says, "And the Lord God said, Behold, man has become one of us." Why? How has he become one of us? "The serpent said to the woman, You shall not surely die. For God hath known the day you eat thereof, your eyes shall be opened, and you shall be as gods." She touched the fruit. Do you have to touch the fruit before you eat it? Do you know what the word touch means? It means euphemistically to lay with a woman. Did you see the Coco commercial? You getting the picture? You're starting to get this? Okay, now watch. Let's go back to that Arch of Titus, because this is what everything's about. This is what the bombing of the Twin Towers is about. This is what the One World Freedom Tower is about. This is what the Arch of Baal is about. This is what the world government's about. This is the whole story. Another race of beings taking over this race. One dying and one starting a whole new race. Lady Gaga. "My performance at the Grammy Awards is about another race of beings being birthed within the human race." That's exactly right. Perfect. Exact. Correct. Well, let's watch. Let's look. Oh, wow. So here is, they call it the Arch of Washington because they it's in Washington Square Park. But y'all know that George Washington, when you walk in the rotunda of, when you walk into the rotunda of the Capitol building, apotheosis of Washington. There it is. Look, oh my gosh. So when you walk into the rotunda of the Capitol building, you look up, there's George Washington looking down, and it says, E Pluribus Unum. Well, one of these guys are upside down. Either these guys are upside down, or he's upside down. But the ones holding the thing, the banner, it says, E Pluribus Unum. You know what that means, right? Many out of one. Many out of one. Like the human race. Many out of one. Well, let's go. So, apotheosis of Washington. Apotheosis of Titus. Do you get it? Man becoming a god, another race of beings. Man who couldn't, you know, start a fire, becoming a man that's got a cell phone where I could talk to China and some guy could speak Chinese and I could understand exactly what he's saying using my iPhone 6, 128 gigs, because I could put on Google Translate and I could hear whatever he's saying. Man becoming like gods. Wow. And here we are back at the Washington Arch, which is in Manhattan, right? There it is. Well, let me tell you a little story. You see that arch right there? Well, you see all the real estate that those buildings are built on? Let me tell you how those buildings got there. Those buildings got there because John Rockefeller and his brother, Nelson Rockefeller, that, by the way, own the Federal Reserve that make the U.S. currency. Those guys served eminent domain and condemned, I believe, 300 businesses that used to be located in the land right here where these buildings are. Okay? Now, the Rockefellers got all this land and had these buildings built. And they made sure they were built right in the center of the apotheosis of Washington, the two becoming a god. Okay, now, how do I know that? Well, because I have the gift of knowledge and wisdom. You know what it says on this arch? As you look through this arch and you see the seat of the serpent and the seat of the woman, do you know what it says on that arch? I do. It says, Exitus octa probat. Most people would never even look it up. Most people would never even notice. I'm going to show it to you. There it is. Don't believe me. See it for yourself. Exitus octa probat. Well, what the hell does that mean? Why do they have that on there? Well, when you understand the spiritual meaning of things, it's easy to see what they're doing. It's always the same thing. It has everything to do with another race of beings. So let's look through the arch. And let me just show you, and let me show you exactly what those words mean. Exitus octa probat means the outcome justifies the deed. Well, what outcome? What deed? It says exitus octa probat, and you're looking through an arch that is the apotheosis. It represents man becoming a god. Well, what is the outcome that is justified by whatever the deed is? Well, let's look at what happened on 9/11. Remember the Twin Tower bombing? Well, did you know if you make a pentagram out of the $20 bill that was made in 1996, this one, and you make that pentagram and you turn it upside down and you draw around the perimeter and you connect the vertices, it makes the Church of Satan. It'll make that star. I'll show you in just a sec. But look how that, look at that. Oh my gosh, look, it's an arch. See the arch right here? Wow. And look at the cutout in the arch. So if I'm looking through this cutout right here, what do I see? Oh, I see the Twin Towers burning. Oh my gosh. The outcome justifies the deed. The destruction of the two DNAs and the destruction of the Twin Towers as a sacrifice is justified by the new race of beings that will take its place, Satan's race. Let me show you. See, there's that One World Freedom Tower in the dead center of the arch. Oh my gosh. Isn't that the one that Obama signed, the very top beam? And it said, we remember, we rebuild, we come back stronger. WWW666. By the way, carbon-based life forms are 6 electrons, 6 neutrons, and 6 protons. 666. Satan owns the flesh. It's his. The flesh is Satan's. So, you see the new race of beings that's represented by the One World Freedom Tower? Satan's new race of beings? Because the other two were wiped out and they were burned as a sacrifice. Think of them burned like on an energy level in order to create the new one in its place. That's what this is all about. Let me show you a perfect representation of what that looks like, because we're going to get to all of this in just a minute. Okay, let me go very slowly. We're going to look at where the Arch of Palmyra is going. It's coming to New York in a couple days, and it's, I believe, it could be the most significant event you've ever seen. Doesn't mean something's got to happen, but I would sure be ready for anything at this point, especially when you see the Oversight Committee having to subpoena the Justice Department. You know that there's a big, big problem. A big, big problem. Let me see if I can very slowly find a perfect example. There we go. Look at that. Oh my gosh. There's the Twin Towers burning right under the arch. I want you to look at that image right there. The Twin Towers burning right under the arch. So the two were destroyed. The two that were in the same host body, the twins as it were, because we are twins inside of each one of us. There's a good you and there's a bad you. There's a right side up you and there's an upside down you. And until you get flipped, you know nothing. Watch. You see those towers burning under the arch right there? You see it? Picture K in your show notes. You see that those are DNA markers? Picture E1 in your show notes. You see it? Burning the two DNAs to create a new race of beings. One World Freedom Tower. There it is. The two were destroyed. They became one. And the One World Freedom Tower was put there. Let me tell you what God said in Genesis 6. And the Lord said, my spirit will not always strive with man, for he is also flesh, yet his days shall be numbered 120. Remember this, there were giants on the earth in those days and also after that. We're going to do a commercial next video. And when the sons of God, Bnei Elohim, came in unto the daughters of men, had intercourse with human women, they bare children to them and same became mighty men, like football players, Olympic athletes, which were men of old, men of renown. So God decided he would destroy the human race because their thoughts were continually wicked, because the two had become one. Well, now let me show you something very grievous. Okay, now, back in 2008, before Obama became president, before he won the Nobel Peace Prize, I did a message, series called the Just a Messenger series. It was the very first thing I'd ever done. I was really shy. I couldn't even hardly look at the camera. And I'm going to go show y'all a quick video. Watch that. Okay, so now here's the Just a Messenger series. Now listen very carefully. I did this in 2008 before Obama became president. Sat around on a video camera for quite a while because I didn't even know how to use YouTube. I had a high school kid named Brandon Zielinski put together this channel and cut this thing into a bunch of pieces. They had to be 15 minutes long to load them up on YouTube for me, which he did. And this particular part, part two, I prophesied. I prophesied, I think, three times since I've been saved. And it is absolutely mind-boggling what's happened out of this prophetic utterance. By the way, in 2003, I was showing everybody these bombings on this currency in 2003. Okay? Now, I'd show, even showing people the federal building bombing on the U.S. currency in 2003. Okay, now, the Lord showed me what's on the $10 bill. The new $100 bill had not even come out yet. But the Lord gave me a prophetic utterance, and I'm going to show you what that prophetic utterance is.
I don't want you to be able to see the whole thing. So you fold the bill in half, and then you fold it in half again. Now, some people would say that you're manipulating the bill to make an image that you want to see, but I'm going to have to contend to you that it makes it even more difficult. You're becoming, you're making an exponential function every time you fold the bill. So there's an image right here that's right above my thumb, and I'm going to turn the page right here. And I'm going to show you that same image. I've taken that image and I've cropped it, and I've put that image right here now. And here's an image of a rectangular building. It's got 1, 2, 3 rows of windows. Here's an image of smoke, and here's an offset in the building, and here's the rest of the building. Now, if you'll go below, here's an image of the Pentagon. It also is exactly the same. It's a rectangular building. It's got 1, 2, 3 rows of square windows. It's got an offset, the same as the image above it, and it's got the smoke, same as above it, and it's got another part of the rectangular building. Okay, that right there, you have two images of bombings in the United States that are printed on this one $20 bill. This one bill was made in 1996. The bombings were done in 2001. So, we have one bill. And it's got an image of the Twin Towers, and it's got an image of the Pentagon on it. Okay, I'm going to go and take the other U.S. currency bill, and I'm going to show you guys right here. These are $20 bills. This is the one that we just made into a pyramid, and this is the old $20 bill that was taken out of circulation. This has been around since I was a child. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you in front of these bills. I've made pyramids out of both of these bills now. Now, Isaiah said, those who try and hide their plans from the Lord are doomed. They carry out their schemes in secret and think no one will see them or know what they are doing. They turn everything upside down. So let's turn them upside down, okay? Once again, here's the Twin Tower bombing on the 20 made in 96. And then on the back side is an image of the Pentagon bombing, which is also shown over here in a larger image. Okay, now let's deal with the old $20 bill. I'm going to go back into your picture. Here's the old $20 bill. So here's a pyramid, and let's turn it upside down. Now I'm going to put that image right here, and I'm going to move it. It's the same image. This is the federal building bombing in Oklahoma City. You can see the concussion waves coming off the building, off this side of the building, and the explosion coming out the top of the building. Now this is where things get extremely fascinating. I'm going to turn this same bill over on the back side, and there's an image right here, and I'm going to take that same image and put it below here, right here. So Dan's going to back up. Now, I want you to watch my finger. Here's the leading edge of the wall. Now, follow my finger down, and there's two floors sticking out right here. Now, watch this. Go to my other finger. Here's the leading edge of the wall, and there's the same exact two floors sticking out, and it follows the wall down. This represents the smoke. And this represents the other part of the building over here. So now on the other $20 bill, you have also a very, very close likeness of the federal building bombing after the explosion and at the point of explosion. You're looking at something that is absolutely impossible. You just saw the Twin Tower bombing and the Pentagon bombing on one bill, and on the other bill, you saw the federal building blowing up, and on the back side of the bill, you saw the aftermath of the explosion right here on the old $20 bill. The odds of that happening have to be somewhere in the neighborhood of an exponential function that's basically, I would imagine, x to about the 10th power thereabouts, whatever x is. I'm not really sure how that variable factor works out, but every time you fold the bill, it has to make it exponentially harder to resemble the bombing of one of our buildings. So anyway, we looked at two bills and you've seen one, two, three, four images of bombings on only the two $20 bills. That's only the $20 bills. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to prophesy for you. The Lord has poured this prophecy into me. And after I prophesy, I'm going to go back and I'm going to show you what those words mean. And it's just fascinating. So let me just take a moment and pray. Lord, I pray that you'll just speak those words through me again so that these people can hear it and understand. And I'm praying that you give everybody that watches this video the eyes to see and the heart to understand and the ears to hear. So thus saith the Lord of hosts, behold, the hand of the oppressor has been lifted against you.
Give me the chills.
And out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem shall cover the city by the sea, and great shall be the destruction of that city. And behold, the great wall which holds back the abundance of the rivers shall burst forth, bringing the hand of the oppressor against you, for I have seen it. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Now behold the abomination of desolation, spoken of by Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place where it should not be. Here is the mystery made known to you. You are the holy place of which I speak. And the abomination of desolation shall rise from within the walls of the temple to destroy the temple. For having not seen and having not heard and hasn't not been made known to you, having not read the scriptures. For when the sons of God came into the daughters of men, they did bear children to them, and the same became mighty men. And has not the sea turned mighty? And the sea shall turn terrible before your very eyes, and the terrible one shall be elevated within the sea. And behold, the man of peace shall come forth from the sea, Barack Hussein Obama, and with words of peace he will bring chaos and destruction. Behold the fig tree. It puts forth its leaves, and suddenly the time is upon you. The travail begins, and a holy nation is to be born, and it will not stop until that nation is brought forth.
All right. There it is. I'm buzzing, man. Oh, my gosh. So while I'm going through this now, here's the thing. After that, Barack Obama won the presidency. After that, Barack Obama won the Nobel Peace Prize? What are you kidding me? And so the utterance said, and behold, the man of peace, Barack Hussein Obama, shall come forth from the sea of humanity, and with words of peace bring chaos and destruction. But what's even more amazing is, for mighty is your enemy that is risen from within your own border. Oh my God, have y'all turned on YouTube lately? Have y'all noticed that within the borders of our country, if Trump wins, Clinton goes to jail, Obama administration, abuse of power exposed by, I mean, what, $300 billion, $33 billion given to Iran by Obama in cash and gold that we don't even know about. Hillary Clinton raping Haiti. I mean, the whole thing is absolutely insane. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Wow. Now behold the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place where it should not be. Here is the mystery made known to you. You are the holy place of which I speak. And the abomination of desolation shall rise from within the walls of the temple to destroy the temple.
It's been a great year, and I'm real happy for myself because I had a great year.
Wow. Those words were uttered back in 2008. Look at this commercial. I broke this down for you. Now, this woman sitting in here, she's starting to be hooked up to a different server. Look at her eyes. Yep, there's a signal interference. She's going to become something different. And now behold the abomination, for mighty is your enemy. Look what happens. Look where she walks out. Look what's right on top of her. See the heart that's divided? It says coat check. It doesn't say defibrillator. You know, coat check. Think about it. A cloak, something you put over you with the heart split. Then she walks out. She becomes a beast. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. He's talking about, when he gave me those words, he wasn't just talking about within the borders of the United States. He was talking about in you, inside the human species. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Let's watch a representation of that in a commercial called Kenzo. For mighty is your enemy. Remember those that wink the eye, devise perverse things. They hated me without cause. Against whom do you sport yourself and stick out your tongue? Are you not the seed of falsehood? There's the one teardrop coming out of the eye, just like the dead sheep. Yes, it was all right, people. Now she's becoming something else. Wink. Jesus said in John 15, they hated me without cause. They hated me and my Father without cause, fulfilling their scriptures. He was quoting Psalm 35:19. Let not them that are wrongfully my enemies rejoice over me, neither let them wink the eye that hate me without cause. Okay, when you stick your tongue out of your mouth, Isaiah 57, against whom do you sport yourselves and stick out your tongue? Are you not the seed of falsehood? The seed of the adulterer and the whore? Wow! A beast! For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. It's not just Obama. It's not just Hillary. It's not just the government that we just had to subpoena the Justice Department to get Hillary's sick, twisted records. It's us. Our borders have been compromised. The human species. Turning into a beast. That's why she's got the X on her chest, X chromosome. That's why it has a triangle in the middle. The pyramid, your enemy. There it is. There is the enemy number one. There's the enemy. That's a representation right there. The new race. Orbis. There she is, dealing with her own self. The good her, the bad her, the mirror reflection. She's going to turn upside down. She's turned upside down. Flesh. This shows a departure from herself. Watch. Now, this is a representation of the garden. Female warrior. It's like the Ian Bud Light commercial. Hi, I'm Kelly. She was an actor. Kelly means female warrior. There she is. That's a representation of the garden. How perfect, right there with the two pillars. Look at the face right here. This is not by accident. Even though this tapestry, you know, this is a tapestry, that's the face of the devil right there. Eye, mouth, horns. See the face of the devil right there? Mouth, eye, horns. Right there, eye, mouth, horns. She can't control herself. She's converting to something else. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Now behold the abomination of desolation. An abomination is something absolutely disgusting, and of desolation that makes desolate the temple of God, which is our bodies. Now, right here is very important. This is two things. It's one going off air, so one goes off air. It's also like a flat line. One dies, and then the new one is on stage. Right there. Interesting, it looks like someone that's crucified. Here comes a new creature. The beast. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Let me just give you another example of what that looks like. Mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Mr. Obama, Miss Hillary Clinton, all this nonsense going on. Chavez having to subpoena the Department of Justice. You gotta be kidding me. That's insane. Remember Giselle walking in the vesica pisces? I mean, just go look at the news. Mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. Do you not know your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit? Well, God's spirit will not strive with man for too long because he's mortal flesh. And I'm telling you, that striving is coming to an end, people. Here it goes. This is like a pagan worship thing. This is just like a pagan worship thing in a trance, bowing down before their pagan god. Right there, yeah. And then she dives through the all-seeing eye and becomes what she's meant to be. A whole new animal. Okay. I told you this was about the Arch of Palmyra, right? It is. That's what I'm really doing a video on. Let me show you what this is all really about. Okay? We just went over what this stands for. Apotheosis. Man becoming a god. The two DNAs have become one. As made manifest in this Kenzo commercial. As made manifest in the Coco Mademoiselle commercial. If I still have it up. No, I don't. Obviously, the Kenzo commercial. Let me show you what's going to happen. I don't know exactly when, but it's going to happen. I guarantee it. And behold, the hand of the oppressor has been lifted against you, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. That's a nuke. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. Let me give you a visual representation of that. There is a visual representation of that water that's going to cover the city by the sea. By the way, which is printed on our $10 bill. Let me get that for you real quick. I'll go to the show notes and show you how valuable these show notes really are. You go here, we have the special projects towards the bottom. Watch this. Here we go. Special projects. Welcome to the world of good and evil. Click on that one right there. Let me show you water as high as the walls of Jerusalem. Okay, you go here. I did the U.S. currency. Dave organizes. Thank you for the computer. Thank you for your help. So here we go. Look. Let me show you what you guys are supporting. You're supporting truth. Okay, here's the new $10 bill that came out. Behold, the hand of the oppressor has been lifted against you, and out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. That is a prophetic utterance that was given to me here in 2008. I was talking about what's printed on the $10 bill. Let me show you. When you see this tree right here, that is not a tree. You see that? That is not a tree. You see that tree? That is not a tree either. The movement is downwards. The wind is this way and this way at the same time. Let me show you what happens when you take this bill and you fold this bill and you turn it into a pentagram and you turn that pentagram upside down, just like Isaiah said, Isaiah 29:15. Woe unto them who go to great depths to hide their plans from the Lord. Their works are in the darkness, and they say, who seeth us, who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay. So let's turn it into a pentagram and turn it upside down. You see the tidal wave coming over the seven-story building? There is a black tidal wave. See it right there? Coming over a seven-story building. If you make a line right where I'm making this cursor, right here is where the stories begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. From here below, that is the reflection of this building in the water right here. You see it? Here's the tidal wave. If you pick this bill up after tracing around it, you can see who's responsible. The church of Satan is responsible for this. And that would be the government. Obama, Hillary, I'm calling you guys out. You guys are children of the devil. You guys are children of the devil. And you've manifested because you're liars. And if you're liars, by definition, the Bible says, Satan is the father of lies, and y'all are liars, so you're children of the devil. End of story. But the good news is, we don't have to do a thing, because the Lord God himself will deal with all of y'all. Now, let me show you what's coming. The new $100 bill came out. It wasn't even made when I did that video in 2008. Let me show you the new $100 bill. There it is. It's got a bell on it, by the way, because they're sounding their alarm. You see these buildings right here? You see these buildings? There's a contrail coming down and impacting. This is water racing between buildings. Here's another building right here. Here's a building right here. I'll enlarge it. By the way, I did this on computer where I checked out the layers of ink, and the layers of ink reveal that this is like a nuclear wind, just destroying everything. That's why the other $10 bill is orange. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea. Okay, now, here is New York being destroyed. It's printed on your new $100 bill. Now, let me go back and show you what that looks like. Let me go show you the arch apotheosis of Washington. Let me show you some images from a movie. I believe it's called The Day After, or maybe it's Sudden Impact. One of those movies. Let me show you some images that just happened to be in those movies. Oh my gosh, is that the Arch of Washington? Oh my gosh, it sure is. Oh my gosh, is that a tidal wave? Oh my gosh, it sure is. Wow, look at that. Just so happens that the apotheosis of Washington happens to have, in a movie, a tidal wave coming through it, destroying everybody. Well, you know what? Let's do a dare to compare. You see all that? Let's take this image, some of these images from this movie, and let's compare them to the $100 bill. You know what? Let's just put them side by side and dare to compare. Let's see. Here is the $100 bill. Here is the Arch of Washington right here. And we cut out the $100 bill and put it right under the Arch of Washington. Wow, it reminds me of the Twin Towers. Oh my gosh. You see? Oh wow, look at that. Water rushing through in between the buildings. Well, let's just do a side by side. Let's just do a side by side. Let's just do a side by side and see if there's any resemblance from the movie and the $100 bill. This is why the FBI is showing up at my house, people. This is the reason. Oh, let's see. Here's a building over here on the right with these square windows. See it? See it? Oh, wow. Look, here's a building over here on this side. Oh, like over here. And here's all the water coming in between them. It's probably a big freaking coincidence. I've laid down my life for y'all. Because let me tell you something, when it's time to come round people up, you can rest assured I'll be one of the first ones they come for. And that's why I put my trust in Christ. And I'm not afraid. I will speak the truth no matter what. I will speak the truth. I am a nonviolent person. I will never seek to exact revenge ever. The Lord will get his revenge. I am a harbinger of doom. Just go look at the Just a Messenger series and tell me I was wrong. Everything the Lord said through me is proven out to be true now. All of it. The Mother Goddess thing. Remember after I got saved, what did Michael tell me to do after I prayed Our Father? Water and light came down me. I was filled. I was anointed with the Holy Spirit. And then Michael said, now you say Hail Mary. And I did, and I felt death, and I knew where death came from. Somehow it was associated with the Virgin. When you turn the Virgin upside down, it becomes a dead sheep. You know what? Just for those people that don't know what I'm talking about, I'll prove it to you. I'll go back to this folder right here. I'm going to go to the Special Projects folder, and I'll show you all how to navigate this. I'm not going to try and hurry. If you don't want to be here and you don't want to learn on this, don't be here. Don't learn it. There you go. So, what was the girl doing in the Kenzo commercial? Let's have a real quick look. Let's go back. I'm just going to tie it together for you because I want you to see it. Let's see. I want to freeze frame it so you understand. Just sit tight. This is important. This is worth waiting for. This is so supernatural. Get ready. We want to get her with that tongue sticking out. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. I said it right here. If you don't believe me, go back and watch it. Oh, wait. Said it right here. Right here, part two. For mighty is your enemy that has risen from within your own borders. He was talking about within the country as well as within our bodies. Now behold the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet. Standing in the holy place. You're looking at it. Watch. Okay, you see the eye closed, the tongue sticking out? Let me show you what that represents. When you take an image of the Virgin and you turn it upside down, which is what they did to us, they put us in a snare. It becomes a sheep with its tongue sticking out. You see the sheep? Eye. This is the top of the head coming down to the ear, going out to the other ear, going off the page. Forehead, this is the fur around the edge. Eye. Coming down the face, nostril. Lips, tongue sticking out. Tongue sticking out. You get it? The temple has been destroyed. The human temple. The temple of God. You're looking at it right there. Now, what does that have to do with the Arch of Palmyra? I told you that's where we're going, right? Well, the $100 bill sure looks like water coming in between buildings, doesn't it? This is water coming in between buildings, and this is your $100 bill when you turn it upside down and you make a pentagram and turn it upside down. Wow, how about that? It's identical. So Did you know they lied to you about where the Arch of Palmyra was going? You know what the Arch of Baal is? It's the Arch of Beelzebub. The Arch of Palmyra, whatever you want to call it. Well, the Arch of Baal, you had to go through the arch in order to go into the Temple of Baal. The Temple of Baal is where they used to sacrifice human bodies, children, to Beelzebub. They'd kill them and throw them in a fire. And then the priests would have sex with all these women, and the next year they would have more sacrifices. Yep. That's what that's all about. So, let me show you where they're going to put that really nifty arch. Now, remember, when the Twin Towers burned, right there on the $20 bill made by Nelson Rockefeller and Company, and there's the Twin Towers that burned right in the middle of the arch, identical, identical, identical to the $20 bill. You're telling me that's a coincidence? You're insane. If you think that's a coincidence, you're insane. They're the ones that built it there. They're the ones that made this money. The outcome justifies the deed. What outcome? The new race of beings, the One World Freedom Tower being built there. You getting the picture? Well, they're going to put the Arch of Baal there now in New York. They lied and they said, "Oh, we don't know where it's going." Liars. They knew where it was going. Let me show you where it's going. Let me show you some pictures first. Here's an aerial map of where it's going right here and here. Do y'all remember Mr. Barack Hussein Obama? Lightning from heaven? No birth certificate? Came out of nowhere. Nobody even knows who this guy really is. Do y'all remember? Mr. Obama wanted to have the museum, Berlin Museum, reconstruct the seat of Satan. This is called the seat of Pergamum in the Bible. This is, the Nazis found this and they took it back to Berlin and reconstructed it. It's the seat of Satan, the seat of Zeus. It's the seat of Pergamum. It's in the Bible. Well, Mr. Barack Obama, this guy right here, he's such a narcissist and he's the host body for Satan. He wanted to have this brought to give his acceptance speech in the Denver Broncos Stadium, but Germany said no. So he reconstructed one, and here it is, and here he is saying, "Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can." Play it backwards. Thank you, Satan. Thank you, Satan. Thank you, Satan. Remember that? So Obama's standing here on a replica of this, accepting his inauguration. Let me show you where the Arch of Baal is going. The Arch of Baal is going to go in front of New York City Hall, because this is about one thing and one thing only, and I've been telling you over and over and over and over and over, over and over and over and over and over again. It's about one thing and one thing only. The destruction of the temple of God and a new race of beings, Satan's race, Satan's government on earth. This is the city hall in New York. This is where they're going to put the Arch of Baal. Let's just change the word Beelzebub to the devil, okay? The arch of the devil, because that's who Beelzebub is, the devil. So they're going to put up the arch of the devil right in front of City Hall, right there. Now, let's have a look at it. Just look at the architecture. Just cover up this part right here with your hands. It's a nice addition if you want to think of things being on a countdown. But let me show you something very telling, very odd. They lied and told everybody they didn't know where it was going. How could you not know where it's going when you're going to put it in front of City Hall? What, you didn't have to get a permit? Give me a break. Well, remember the Arch of Palmyra that Lightning from Heaven wanted to have his speech on? Remember at the Denver Broncos Stadium? There it is, Arch of Palmyra. I mean the Seat of Pergamum. And here's a replica of the Seat of Pergamum, the same shape, design, while the Antichrist stands on it, saying, "Yes, we can. Thank you, Satan." Okay, well, oddly enough, that's exactly what the City Hall in New York looks like. Let me take this picture and put it over here, like, da, 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 oh my gosh, it's the same, oh my gosh, oh no, Mr. Bill, oh no, Mr. Bill, it's the same. So, wow, so it looks pretty much, it's the same type layout as the Arch of Palmyra. It's very much identical to Obama's replication of the Arch of Palmyra. I mean, the way the Arch of the Seat of Pergamum. So it looks just like the Seat of Pergamum, doesn't it? Which was the seat of Satan, which was Satan's government. And here we have Chavez, God bless his heart, Ray Gowdy, God bless him, trying to get to the bottom of Hillary's despicable, evil, lying, narcissistic, demonic behavior. By the way, raping the money that was given to Haiti is one of the most abominable things ever. That her and Bill Clinton raised $4 billion and apparently only about 120 something million ever made it to the Haitian people that were literally screwed by the Clintons and stole all that money. Wow. Looks like this was right. Just a messenger. All glory to God. Now, I wanted to get this out, and I wanted to make sure that I at least got this out, because it's coming. I'm sorry I'm dressed like this. I'm wearing my coveralls, do-rag, and construction, and I've been working myself, just killing myself, trying to get a project done that the Lord told me to do, and I have to finish it. But I also needed to make sure y'all understood what the hell's coming. Everything else in the prophetic utterance was right on the money. There's only one thing that hasn't happened. Behold, the great wall, which holds back the abundance of the rivers, shall burst forth. It's a Hoover Dam. It will happen. Out of the sea shall come fire and smoke and a devouring wind. Water as high as the walls of Jerusalem will cover the city by the sea, and great shall be the destruction of that city. Let me show you a tidal wave printed on U.S. currency. There it is. I mean, either you don't believe that's a tidal wave covering a seven-story building, and that's a reflection, or you can see it. If you can see it, God bless you. Praise God. If you can't, God have mercy on you. Because that's what it is. And there's a prophetic utterance that backs it up. So, here we go, folks. This may be it. Who knows? We never know. We never know. But I'm giving you everything I've got to try and warn you. I'm a harbinger. Ding, 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 ding. Ding, 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 ding. Go look up the meaning of the name Jonathan. It means Yahweh has given. Go look up the meaning of Klek, K-L-E-C-K. It'll say it's a variant of the word Glock, G-L-O-C-K. It means a town crier, someone who rang a bell to draw attention, to sound an alarm. Yahweh has given a town crier. Yahweh has given a messenger that rings a bell. I am ringing the bell, people. Wake up. It's time to go. It's coming. No one knows the hour of the day. If people say they know the hour of the day, they're not God's people. Okay? Because we all know. He comes like a thief in the night. And he doesn't say, oh, I'll be there this day. And the people that say they know that, they're arrogant and they're full of pride. And they think that, oh, they're special and they know the day. That's not what the Word of God says. Okay, I've warned you. Peace and grace, guys. You know what? I'm just so disgusted with what's going on this planet. I don't belong to this planet anymore. I've been born from above. But this planet is bad, 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 bad. That's why when you're born from above, you can see how bad it really is. It is bad. And that's your condition right there. There's a good you, and there is a bad you. Be reconciled by the blood of Christ. All right, God bless, guys. By the way, thank you for the computer. And thank you for, you know, that y'all have stepped up to help this ministry out, because we are getting hammered under attack. All right, God bless.